Hey, YouTube, time for a little midweek maintenance, right? So those of you who watched the install for all of the bulletproof design stuff knows that I had a little issue with this guard, this Acerbis frame protector guard, and the bulletproof design's frame protector, or swing arm protector. So a couple pieces of plastic cut off with a razor blade, and now it all fits. It all is well secured again. It's got the band around it, the magnet holding the front, so that's all good to go now. So the pieces do work together if you modify them a little, which I find that you have to do that a lot on anything when you start adding products from different companies together. So she's all good to go now. The next thing that we're going to be looking at is the tires on this sucker. So there's still a tiny bit of rubber left as far as the actual height of the knob, but not much. But that's not really what's bugging me the most. It's all of the side knobs are cracking off. In the back, you know, you can see some, but they don't look too bad. But the front is like literally there's chunks torn off, whole knobs torn off. Like, I mean, that's a whole knob is gone. But the rest of them, even if they're not gone, it's the same thing. They're almost torn off. They're getting close to torn off. That one's missing big chunks. You know, I just don't have to look very far to find these big chunks getting torn off everywhere. So, man, when the dirt is on the tire, it makes it really hard to focus on it. There we go. Anyhow, all these chunks are getting torn off and torn up. These are MX-33s. These are the original tires that came on the bike. I did end up checking the tire pressure on this tire on the front for one time because it felt soft one day. So I put it back up to like 1415. So it's had 1415 PSI in it pretty much the whole time. I think it was when I checked it, it was at 13. So I just put two more in it and called it good. So it's been pretty stiff, pretty tight. This bike just has tubes in it. It doesn't have any tubeless or any, you know, anything like that to help out, protect the rims. So I just went ahead and went with high pressure. The bike handles fine with it like that. And then the rear, I still has never checked. never had to put air in it. It is on the stiff side. I would say, you know, 13 to 15 PSI probably in the rear too. I don't know. But the same thing. No tubeless, no mousse. So I went ahead and left it at high pressure just so that I didn't have to worry about the rims or pinch flats or any of that. So since these are the 33s and they don't really make the 33s anymore, I think the 33s are being phased out and in lieu of the 34. I just went ahead and said screw it. Instead of trying to get the 33s again, went ahead and ordered a new set of 34s. So it'll be the same size, but it'll be the MX-34s. We'll get slapped back on this girl, get her some new shoes, some fresh grip. It'll probably be really weird having fresh grip on her because they've been slowly going dull for the whole time I've had her. And I was just messing around with this. 70 hours. So almost 71 hours. So we're almost at 80. At 80, I've already got the rebuild kit, new piston and all that stuff to go in it. So we'll do a new piston, ring, piston pin, bearing, check our bottom end while we're in there. Probably going to clean out my exhaust valve, spray it all off and clean it off good. All the mechanism that actuates it and everything while we're in there. But I want to take a look at all that stuff. 32:1 has been our mix, so it's you know, very oily, but I don't ride it often bogged way down. I'm in a mix of, you know, ripping it high RPM and keeping it on the pipe and a mix of grunting around low. So it kind of gets ridden both ways. But I don't think we're going to find much buildup or anything. So we're almost there. Another 10 hours. And I'll probably try and time all this stuff to happen all at the same time. So we'll get another 10 hours on the bike on these tires. And then we'll be able to do the tires, the FMF, the top end, all that, all at one time. So when we come back to this bike again, it'll be all fresh looking again. New tires, new piston, you know, new top end, all that, refreshed, new exhaust, and then we'll go out and give her a try again and see what she's like. Boop, boop. All right, guys, the new tires arrived today, at least the rear tires. I went ahead and bought two rears at the same time. The front tire is still coming in the mail, but went ahead and grabbed two of them. These are the MX34s. So the bike came with 33s, did really good the whole time, but went ahead and decided I was going to give these 34s a try. These are supposed to be, you know, product improved over the 33s, so heard lots of good things about them. My buddies really like them, so going to go ahead and give these a try and see how they do. Boop, boop. Hey, guys. So out here hanging up the O'Neill sign and my first helmet. Kind of hard to see the first helmet back there in the back. But getting those hung up on the wall, and I realized it's not really too bad for temperature-wise out here. So I then, you know, of course, if it's not going to be so hot that I'm super-duper dying, then I might as well find something to play around with. So I've been out here polishing the silencer and the pipe that originally came off the CR250 and using the prime pads to get it all cleaned up and everything. Pretty much all done, for at least as far as I can reach on it and everything. There's a couple super tight spots that I can't get everything, and this thing had so many years of fouled up carbon in it that had to dig a lot of that out. There's big old, you know, rings of it laying around. Got some of it cleaned out. It's pretty much about as clean as I can get it now, so it is what it is, but boy, it sure looks nice now compared to what it did. Haven't even put a polish to it or a rag to it or anything, just the Scotch-Brite so far, and I had to go get a little bit of contact cleaner or brake cleaner just to get some of this stuff down in there that I can't get the Dremel tool to, can't get the buffing wheel to, so I'm just going to go ahead and get some contact cleaner in there, try and clean that up. I took the torch last time we screwed around with this to the screen, and now it's super clear, super clean and nice, you know, all burned off, but it was all completely plugged when I pulled it out, so I don't know, just finding stuff to screw around with. I still need some more tools to be able to finish the motor tear down apart, so that's just waiting in the wings. I ran out of money to have the frame and the rims powder coated, so they're still just sitting here waiting. Whenever I get the chance, I'm going to take the frame in and have it powder coated. The rims are going to get powder coated, or the hubs anyway. So as money is available, keep doing it. I just thought I'd throw this in since I was out here screwing around in the shop and it was feeling nicer and everything, and hanging up the nice banner, American flag off my guitar amp when I was younger, my helmet, all the tires on the wall, getting a pretty good selection and stock going in tires now, so that's good to you. Next thing I'll probably screw around with is polishing that pipe up a tiny bit. It's pretty much thrashed because it's been bent and welded right at the neck, but maybe somebody wants it. Maybe I can find somebody who wants to buy it. If not, then I'll just start on polishing the swing arm, get all nice and cleaned up and shiny. All right, guys, later. So checking out my prime aluminum polishing kit. I went ahead and used the first roughest wheel with the roughest black compound first. So this is where we're setting at after just the first polishing wheel. Got two more to go. Got number two on there. I'm ready to get some number two polishing compound on there, and it's looking pretty freaking nice already. I can't imagine after I get done with all three. Let's go. Woohoo, doggy. I still haven't even actually taken a hand cloth to it at all. I just got done spinning down the third polisher on it. But dang. This is an old, beat up, crusty, rusty silencer. Now this thing looks like $1 million, man. Pretty amazing. Pretty amazing. Prime wheels doing their job, man. Doing real good.